this has multiple functions. First, the water comes down here. Now, on your water collection system, in theory, on this roof, I could collect 850 gallons if I channeled all of the water directly into the tank. But when it first starts to rain, the roof is dirty. It's going to have dust, leaves, possible animal droppings on it. So they recommend that you scrub the first 1 to 2 gallons per square foot. No, I'm sorry, per 100 square feet. So to make the numbers easy, let's just call it 1,000 square feet, and then at 100, a gallon per 100, you need 10 gallons. At 2 gallons per 100, you need 20 gallons to scrub the roof. There's a lot of factors in that. The roof pitch is a factor. The size of the roof is a factor. I consider a little bit more than the formula. If you go up on this roof and dump 20 gallons of water across the entire roof, that's not much. So I didn't figure that was enough. The more water that you use to clean the roof, obviously the cleaner your water is going to be. Now, it's also the less water you collect. So, as a balance for myself in a comfort level, I wanted to scrub at least 40 gallons off the roof. Normally, what people will do with a smaller roof is they'll use this 4-inch PVC pipe as a first flush diverter. And that's what they call it when you divert off the roof water that you don't want into your tank. First flush diverter. So if I wanted to use this pipe to divert off 40 gallons, I would need 80 feet of pipe. 4-inch pipe holds a half a gallon a foot. This stuff costs $15 for a 10-foot length. That's a lot of money for 80 feet of pipe to control dirty water. I didn't want to do all that. I didn't want to spend that much. You're talking almost $150 per side, because I have two independent systems here. $150 per side for waste water. Instead, what I came up with was these blue barrels. I already had these barrels, and these have a sealed lid, and they have a locking mechanism which holds the lid on. You could use the cheaper one-piece barrels. It would be exactly the same, except you couldn't clean the inside. These I can take one, clean it out, and then just do a swap, and it's ready to go again in 5 minutes. The other barrels, they're going to get dirty, and you're going to need to figure out how to clean them. You may be able to pressure wash them or whatnot, but it's going to be a lot more work. So these barrels are really nice. So in my system, what I have happen here is my fresh water comes in. It comes down into this barrel, the first 50-ish gallons. Then this barrel's all sealed tight, so the water fills up the barrel and fills up this pipe. Inside this pipe is a ball, and that ball will go up into this piece here and plug it off. And once that fills up with all the dirty water and plugs off, then the clean water comes in this pipe. Meanwhile, out the bottom of this barrel, we have 3/8 PEX pipe. So we have a fitting that I just drilled a hole in the barrel and threaded that fitting in. No tap or anything. And then I just attached my PEX plumbing. At the end of my PEX plumbing, I have a standard 3/8 valve. This is like what you would find in a house that's plumbed with PEX under a sink as a shutoff valve. That's all this is. So I can take that valve and open it at any position between full open and full closed, controlling the release rate of the roof water in this barrel. I currently have it set to just trickle out. And I'll explain how advantageous that valve can be in a different segment. So my water comes in, it always drains out at a slow rate, so my dirty water will leave. This fills up with clean water, a ball inside here closes this off, and this here is a diverter valve. It's a special piece. This isn't a normal piece that you're going to find at Home Depot. Inside is a cone shape, which allows the ball to plug off the hole. Then, while this is plugged off, a little water will trickle out of here and the level will drop, and then the fresh water will fill it up again. So it's constantly dropping and filling. You know, it's going to be act like a little valve, click, 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 and the fresh water goes in the tank. As long as the water flows into this faster than I have the drain set to drain. So then the water comes in here and fills up the tank. I have it filling in from the top. Now what that does is that keeps the bottom settled, so the dirt and stuff at the bottom isn't going to be stirred up.